Hello, I'm Brigantia Blackbird of Blackbird's Brew, and welcome back to Wicca 101. This is the beginning of a series of classes about altar tools, and specifically, we're going to be going through them one at a time, and we're going to begin with the athame. So what is an athame exactly? The brief definition is that it is a witch's ritual knife. It represents the element of air, or sometimes the element of fire, depending on specific traditions, but usually the element of air. But it also represents the will of the witch. It is a phallic symbol, and for obvious reasons, it represents the god and all of masculine deity. Now, specifications about athames are going to vary from tradition to tradition, coven to coven, and individual to individual. But generally speaking, the blade is between 6 to 9 inches, and it is double-edged. In the case of my own, I think that's about 6 inches-ish, and it is double-blade. Now, if you'll notice, the two sides of the athame, they gradually come closer and closer together until they are as one at the absolute point and tip of it. And this gradual coming together, it symbolizes the union between the masculine and the feminine, of the spiritual and the material, and of order and of chaos. Now the sides, they can be sharp or dull. I prefer to have mine dull. And of course, they both sides represent the god and the goddess. Now, the blade also evokes kind of a sense of responsibility. To wield magic is to wield considerable power. Even if your talents are modest, magic is not a toy, and an athame is definitely a reminder of that. Now, let's look at the hilt. The hilt of an athame, it can be made from any number of materials, including horns, wood, or metal, as in the case of mine. It is traditional for the handle to be black or quite dark, but this is not an absolute requirement, as you can plainly see. That's not how mine is. And sometimes the hilts are quite simple. Mine has a little bit of detail to it. It really depends on what suits you and what you can afford. But also, the hilt should fit comfortably in your hand. It shouldn't be awkward in any way. If it's awkward, it's going to be a distraction to you in your ritual work. Now, as is the case with all altar tools, before you use the athame for the first time, it's strongly advised to cleanse, charge, and dedicate the tool for your specific use. And methods will be discussed for the most common ways of doing this after all the tools have been introduced within the class. So stay tuned for that. We've got a ways to go. One last note, in just to keep generally in mind with all of the altar tools, is that it is extremely bad form to touch someone else's tools without their permission. The tools, especially over a period of time, they become deeply infused with an individual's energy to the point where it actually becomes an extension of that person. So, no touchy-touchy. Now this brings us to the function of the athame. The athame is used to focus energy. The purpose is both to direct and to command where that energy goes and what it's going to be doing. Most often in our rituals, it's used when summoning or dismissing the quarters. When athames are used to cut, the only thing they're cutting is energy and air. Never, ever anything else. If it should happen that the athame draws blood by accident, which can happen, especially if you're left-handed like me and prone to having butterfingers, but at bare minimum it will be necessary to clean and cleanse the blade as well as to reconsecrate it. Now some traditions and practitioners will even go so far as to say that if the blade has any contact with blood of any kind, it needs to be destroyed entirely. That is not a universal belief, but I think by mentioning it, it does, I think, convey the seriousness with which this is viewed. Now, alternatives. Because athames can be expensive to buy, few of us have the skills and the materials and tools required to make one ourselves. So getting a budget option for an athame is not only acceptable, it's actually quite common. In a pinch, a common kitchen knife, preferably with a black handle, will suffice. And in fact, that's what I used for years and years. It worked. It got the job done. But for a no-money option, you can use your index finger. You can do it. It's a little bit harder for the visualization. There is something about having something physical in your hand that just makes all the visualization efforts a lot easier, but you can do it. The point is that when you're practicing Wicca or any form of witchcraft, this doesn't necessarily cost money. And if you know your stuff and you educate yourself about alternatives, you'll find there are more options than what you might have first thought. There's always more than one way to get a job done. So that's our brief introduction into Athames. So our homework for December 4th through the 10th. Do an internet search on Athames and make a note of what designs appeal to you and which don't. And then make a note of the asking price of anything that you do think is pretty nice. Secondly, investigate the process for how knives and swords are actually made. Take notes if you think this is something you'd like to learn more about. Even if you're not in a position to learn now, that could be a goal you would want to meet in the future. And third, as an exercise, first, rub your palms together to build some energy. Now, with your palms still together, visualize all that energy moving into your dominant hand. Then make a fist. Hold the energy in, and then extend your index finger and visualize a blue-white light shooting out from your finger. Then call the energy back into your finger, and then repeat this exercise several times, and then send the energy back into the ground and release it. And that'll give us something to talk about at our class, which will be held Sunday, December 5th at 3 p.m. Central Time in the Workshop Voice Channel on our Discord server, Blackbird's Brew, which if you haven't already joined, there will be a link to do so in the description box below. We would love to have you. And in the meantime, please like, subscribe, leave a comment here, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.